Hello. I don't know how many of you actually care about fashion, but I'm pretty obsessed with it. And there's two ads this month that really stand out to me for completely different reasons, and I want to talk to you about them both. The first one is Gap's hashtag dress normal, and the second one being in Dior's campaign right now. The first picture we have is the beautiful Elizabeth Moss, Peggy from Mad Men. We have the words dress like no one is watching, and at the bottom, dress normal. And in a lot of the advertisements online, and when you see it even at the store, it always says hashtag dress normal. I would like to point out the very obvious and say that this girl is not dressed normal for the beach. Number two, I kind of almost feel judged by Gap. Like, it's because of you that our clothes are not selling. Start dressing normal. And number one, I am dressed normal. I'm just not dressed with boring clothes. And let's just be honest, if we were to dress like nobody is watching, none of us would be wearing pants at any point in time. Let's take a look at the second image. You tell me again, dress normal, but you go ahead and put a woman that is like the embodiment of the most abnormal family we've ever seen, which is the Addams family. And you tell me to dress normal? Again, there's just a mismatch of ideas in this entire campaign. Well, I don't know what really gets to me about this ad campaign is that for so long, media and advertisements especially, has been used against the consumer to make us feel inferior, like we need their products. And instead of like winning us over with like really cool clothes that we want to wear every day, the Gap is like chastising us and telling us like we're abnormal. Like, it's because of you that we're not selling clothes. When I honestly have been in their store a couple of times in the past 2 years just to check out what they're selling, and they're not really selling anything cute or nice or cool. They're just wearing boring clothes, and I don't think anybody wants to wear boring clothes. I would really like to take this short moment to make a public announcement and let you know that Gap is not called The Gap. It's called Gap. The other ad that really stands out to me in my mind is for a positive reason. It's a Dior campaign for the fall of 2013. I have to admit that it was really the commercial that made me value this campaign. You really see all the girls, the same women that are in this picture, you see them in the same setting, and they're just kind of going in and out having conversations, and it really felt like that idea, you know, that idea they present to us always in TV, in stories, about little girls having like a tea party. It really gave me that sense that these women were having a really expensive grown-up version of a tea party, and they're just there with their best clothes, hanging out with their like friends. I don't know why, because it gives you more of that feeling because there's movement in the commercial, as opposed to seeing them in a more static way when you look at the magazine. But even so, the body language is so neutral in all these pictures. You get the idea that these women do not have a negative relationship to one another. If they don't have a negative, then there's a possibility that they're friends again. And so the reason why this advertisement stands out to me is because there isn't that many advertisements celebrating women, being friends with women, and interacting positively with other women. And how sad that that's an innovative idea in 2014. But I guess we're going one step at a time. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you still are, if you missed the other video I made today, you can see it here. Thank you. Have a good day.